selfish, I guess, from a race goer's point of view, because we need so much rain. But from a racing perspective, it won't have any adverse effect at
what
the moment.
What is in your hand?
Well, I just thought you'd ask that. This is the baseball that was broken by John out there, John Taylor, the eighth Dan, karate expert. Mm. And you talk about people who don't flinch.
Yeah.
This bit hit Mal, who took that shot, our cameraman, and he didn't move. You see how steady that shot
it's
was?
It's like a toothpick.
And it hurt too, didn't it, Mal?
Good on you, Mal. Well
You're
done.
Good man. All right, we'll see
you all tomorrow from He's Melbourne. Have a great
see
day.
You,
bye-bye.
Hey everyone, welcome to Mornings on this, the 2nd of November, and I'm delighted to be in Melbourne. I feel a bit royal this morning because the Lord Mayor, John Soh, has personally come along to welcome us. Good morning, John.
Good morning, Kerri Anne. Welcome to Melbourne. We are very excited to have you in our city.
Well, we're...
Now, let us give Kerri Anne a Melbourne welcome.
Oh! Wonderful, John, wonderful. They're looking good this morning, aren't they? I love it. I've got a Lord Mayor as my warm-up man. This is fantastic. It is terrific to be here. You've got lots of plans. Of course, the Spring Racing Carnival is underway. But, you know, there's been some tough times in Victoria, the same as New South Wales, Queensland, in the grip of drought. And yesterday, as Lord Mayor, you had to take a pretty big and tough decision.
Oh, yes. We have to turn off all the fountains in the cities. Mm. I mean, look, we have all these magnificent, lovely fountains. But in response to the water restriction, we have to save as much water as possible.
Well, good decision. Good decision, people?
Yeah.
Yeah. Terrific. But I do have to say that we think we've broken the drought because we got here this morning. There's a bit of rain, right?
Yeah.
And we're excited. Again, thank you very much, Lord Mayor. We're looking forward to a fabulous show. And boy, do we have a great show. Two wonderful musical talents. Guy Sebastian is with us this morning. He's got his latest single. That'll be happening very, very shortly. But after 10:30 on Mornings, a man with many, many Grammys to his credit, John Mayer, will be live in the studio. Also... Oh, she's gone. Oh. Are you excited by
yes.
that? Oh, and Guy Sebastian? Oh, what about Red Simons?
Yes.
Joe Stanley?
Yes.
Oh, Rhonda Birchmore?
Yes.
Jerry Connolly?
Yes.
There's so much on.
There is so much on. John Soh?
Yes.
Oh, good.
Also, Jeff Kennett joins us this morning, along with footballer Nathan Thompson. So a wonderful lineup again, Lord Mayor. Thank you for welcoming us so well. We've got more coming up, our monthly trivia challenge, and we're just going to have a good day. A fabulous audience, so let's get this show on the road. About 3 years, almost 3 years, since Guy Sebastian took home the Idol crown. Now, three albums later, he is continuing to live up to that title. The latest album, it's called Closer to the Sun. He's with us live on Mornings to kick off with a track, Guy Sebastian with Elevator Love.
I'm addicted to the sound.
So tell me it's over, so we can't do it all again. I'm addicted to this elevated love. Tell me you miss me, and I will come back for one more day. I'm addicted to this
than he's ever sung?
Yeah!
Oh, thanks. It's a shiny shoes.
Oh, very cool shoes.
Is this for me?
That is for you, and you deserve a sip. And Carl, thank you very much. Great song. It
looks
fabulous. Everybody yay in the studio has done a fab job. But you are, recently we've been working together on another little project we'll tell you all about next week.
Oh, yes, that's
but
right.
But you, I noted last night that you, and especially today, are singing better than I've ever heard you.
Oh, thanks. I guess I've really found a place for my voice just in kind of the last 6 months. I started writing for this album on guitar as opposed to, usually I sort of write on piano, and me and Carl, who you saw earlier, we've written a lot together as well. And for some reason, doing that has caused me to sing different. And the new style of music that I've been doing as well is a little kind of rockier. I mean, you know, a little while ago, it was kind of a lot more soul focused. And like I'd had a song, for example, called Out With My Baby, and I would have sung it like almost in the back of my throat, and it was a bit insular. Like it was kind of like, in the club, it's jumping, everyone's pumping, I'm with my baby. But now, I'm kind of singing out a bit where it'd be more, in the club, it's jumping, everyone's pumping, I'm with my baby. So I'm kind of throwing my voice out.
Yay! Throw it anywhere you want.
But I like it. I mean, it's funny, as singers, you always go through different phases with your gift, and you try and kind of stretch yourself and keep
it exciting. Closer to the Sun, this new album, explain the title.
I guess it was a title I eventually got to. I went through a number of different options and eventually got to this song. It's actually a song on the album, and it's really a song about departure. And I guess for some people, when they listen to albums, they really want to put something on and get away from kind of, you know, the rat race, which is life sometimes. And I know for me, when I put on, you know, Rubber Soul by the Beatles or you know, Inner Visions by Stevie Wonder or something, it just takes me to another place. And I guess the lyrics in the title track, Closer to the Sun, like the first verse is all about getting away. It's, excuse me, friend, can you tell me when did I sign up for this race? There's not an end and no one wins, yet you fight to keep the pace. And basically we wrote that looking out at busy life in Sydney and looking out at traffic and just wanted
and
to kind of...
And the whole celebrity thing, which has been, you know, this has been a tough corner for you to turn.
Yeah, it's been a full-on time. I mean, it's a...
Because people are kind. I went for a walk in a hotel with you last night. I got to tell you, it took me forever. You know, you can't go anywhere. Everybody pulls you up. Most people are fabulous, but occasionally there are some cruel and hurtful people.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, it's
What's
one of those things.
What's the cruelest thing that's been said?
I guess it's just an ongoing thing. I mean, I can't really define
they've
it to one
pelted
thing.
Pelted your car and your house with eggs.
Yeah, yeah. That was a little while ago, and I guess it's just one of those things. I mean, with our lives, it's quite a good percentage of good versus bad. Because my life is like 98% amazing. Like I'm getting to do music, and then there's that little percentage which you're just not used to. Like I went from total obscurity to this strange life, and you know, like you don't have people doing that to you really in normal life, or saying stuff straight to your face, or so it's definitely something I had to kind of get used to.
Well, you are dealing with it so very, very well. The album is terrific. You, as I said, sounding better than ever.
Oh,
you
thank
found
you.
That other place, and we all have to graduate as people and performers.
Absolutely.
And I'm very grateful today because I asked and you graciously accepted to hang around and have a chat with us this morning with Jeff Kennett, who is the chairman of a foundation that deals with depression, also a footballer who's going to be very difficult and very brave to talk about this. It's an extraordinarily difficult problem, and not that you've suffered depression, but you've been through a couple of rocky roads, so you're going to have a chat to us and join the conversation.
Beautiful, absolutely.
Wonderful. Ladies and gentlemen, Guy Sebastian. And let's not forget some of the store appearances that Guy's making. We'll put those details up on the screen. If you missed them, just go to our website. Guy's working around. But last time I saw Jamie, he was sort of headed down around the studio. Where are you, Jamie?
I was on my way to the cafeteria, but I thought I'd stop here. This is the Channel 9 Melbourne Hall of Fame. Can I take you back past some of these years gone by? Look, this Graham Kennedy, 1971, the comedy specials with Bert here. Come along, come along, come along. Cartoon Corner, 1972, where Hey Hey It's Saturday started. That's cool. Don Lane Show, 1975 to 1983. I grew up watching the Sullivans in Christchurch, New Zealand. Can you believe that? 1976 to 83. That's a beauty. Paul Hogan Show. They don't make him like that anymore, Kerri Anne.
Oh, yeah.
Dell Summers Family Feud. We did Family Feud. Look at that. Back in 1980 to 82 and Bert and Patty there. But going through all these old faces and TV legends, I noticed that there was one very important Australian TV legend, Kerri Anne, that actually wasn't up here. So I thought I'd rectify that. Someone very close to my heart. And, of course, the star of Mornings with Kerri Anne. Picture, please. I'll just pop him up over here. So we can... Is he all right? Organise some lights or something around flashing. Anyway, lots more great stuff coming up. Big stars on the show. We've got John Mayer, we've got Rhonda Birchmore, we've got Red Simons, loads more. Straight after the break, the latest in bikinis. Yeah.